have said good night.
Yes. We have got something very special in bed. Right?
Right.
Ladies and gentlemen, the chum of Captain Mortra wish to say good night to you.
Thank you.
It's so kind of you to offer to help me.
I'm delighted, Maria. Now, I told you, you must wear that lovely little dress you were wearing the other evening when the captain couldn't keep his eyes off you.
Eyes off me?
Come, my dear, we are women. Now let's not pretend that we don't know when a man notices us.
The captain notices everybody and everything.
There's no need to feel so defensive, Maria. You're quite attractive, you know. The captain would hardly be a man if he didn't notice you.
Baroness, I hope you're joking.
Not at all.
But I never did a thing
but
to
you. But you don't have to, my dear. There is nothing more irresistible to a man than a woman who is in love with him.
In love with him?
Of course. And you know what makes it so nice is? He thinks he is in love with you.
But that's not true.
Don't take it to heart, Maria. He'll get over it soon enough. Men do, you know.
Then I mustn't stay here. I must go.
Is there anything I could do to help?
No, nothing. Baroness, please don't say a word about this to the captain.
Oh no, I wouldn't dream of it. I feel like celebrating.
You know something?
Perhaps.
Then, if you are so clever, tell me how to have Maria to use her influence with Georg. I want those children at the festival, Elsa. It's important to Austria.
Wouldn't do you any harm either.
Yes. I've thought of that.
Well, if it is a matter of influence, maybe the one you should be talking to is me.
Oh, really?
Maria decides to leave the Fontrap villa and return to the abbey. That Maria is no longer a part of the Fontrap family, the children are once more on their own. Max tries to enliven the atmosphere in the villa by coaxing the children to sing and play.
Hey, come on, children. Don't feel so sad. Get up. Let's sing. Let's have a rehearsal.
What for?
Let's make believe that we are standing on the stage at the festival.
I don't feel like singing. Not without Fräulein Maria.
Kurt, get us the guitar. Come on, Friedrich, take your place. Come on, Gretel. Come on, Brigitte, take your places. All in your group, You know your places. Get them. That's right. Now, be cheerful. Right. Kurt, give us the key. Now, impress me. Okay, so I see. You people don't feel like singing. All right, let's play catch.
Yes, Uncle Max.
Friedrich.
Uncle Max.
Liesel.
The Baroness too does Brendan. Her bit by Brina. Trying half-heartedly.
2, 6. Baroness Radha. We're very tired now. Could we do this some other time?
Whatever you want, dear. We'll do it again tomorrow.
I get a fiendish delight thinking of you as a mother of 7. Elsa, how do you plan to do it?
Darling, haven't you ever heard of a delightful little thing called boarding school?
Baroness Machiavelli.
Uncle Max. Where's father?
I think he's somewhere around.
Enjoying your cool summer drink, Max, isn't it?
Yes, of course, Georg. Why don't you try some?
Father?
Yes?
Is it true that Fräulein Maria isn't coming back?
Fräulein Maria? Yes, I suppose it's true.
I don't believe it, Father.
But didn't I tell you what her note said? Oh, I'm sure I did. She said she missed her life at the Abbey too much. And that's all there is to it.
But she didn't even say goodbye.
She did in her note.
Oh, that isn't the same thing.
Father?
Yes?
Who is our new governess going to be?
You are not going to have a governess anymore.
We are not?
No. You are going to have a new mother.
A new mother?
We talked about it last night. It's all settled, and we all are going to be very happy, isn't it? All right, now run off and play.
Come, children, I'll join you.
The children are unable to understand this new change. They want Maria back in their lives and so decide to go to the Abbey to bring her back.
Yes, my children.
My name is Liesel.
Yes, Liesel.
We, my brothers and sisters, are here to see Fräulein Maria.
Oh, Maria. I'm very sorry, children. But Maria is in seclusion. She hasn't been seeing anyone.
But she'll see us. I know she will.
She's a governess. We
She didn't even say goodbye.
All we want to do is talk to her.
I want to show her my little finger.
Oh, some other time, dear. I'll tell Maria that you were here. It was sweet of you to come. But now, go along,
Please, sister.
What was that all about, Sister Margareta?
The Fontrap children, Reverend Mother, want to see Maria.
Has she spoken yet? Did she tell you anything?
But she doesn't say a word, Reverend Mother, except in prayer.
Oh, poor child.
It's strange, Reverend Mother. She seems happy to be back here. And yet she's so unhappy.
Sister Margareta, could you go get Maria here, please?
Yes, Reverend Mother.
Seem to be unhappy. I'm sorry.
Reverend Mother.
But why did they send you back to us?
They didn't send me back, Mother. I left.
Maria, tell me, what happened?
I was frightened, Reverend Mother.
Frightened? Were they unkind to you?
Oh, no. No. I was confused. I felt the way I never felt before. Oh, Mother, I couldn't stay there. I just couldn't. I knew I'd be safer in the Abbey.
Maria, our Abbey is not to be used as an escape. What is it that you can't face?
I can't face him again, Mother.
Him? Captain?
Phone trap.
Are you in love with him?
I don't know. The Baroness said I was. She said he was in love with me. But I didn't want to believe it. Oh, there were times when we would look at each other. Oh, Mother, I could hardly breathe.
Well, did you let him see how you felt?
If I did, I didn't know. That's what's been torturing me. I was there on God's errand. To have asked for his love would have been wrong. Oh, Mother, I'm ready at this moment to take my vows. Please help me.
Maria, the love of a man and woman is holy too. You have great capacity to love. What you must do is find out where God wants you to spend this love.
But I pledged my life to God. I pledged my life to his service.
Thank you. Maria. If you love a man, that does not mean that you love God any less. No, you must go back. You must find out.
Oh no, Mother. You can't ask me to do that. Please, I beg of you.
Maria, these walls were not built to shut out problems. You have to face them. You have to live the life you were born to live.
Their attempt unfulfilled, the children sadly returned home and were faced by an interrogating father.
Where were all of you? Now, it's not like my children to be secretive.
We're not being secretive, Father.
And it's not like my children to be late for dinner either.
Father, we had lost track of time.
I see.
Yes.
So, who's going to be the first one to tell me the truth? Louisa? Is that going to be Liesl?
Where do you think we were, Father?
Friedrich.
Father, we had gone berry picking. Yes,
berry picking.
Aha. So, where are the berries?
We ate them.
You ate them?
Yes, they were very delicious.
Very well. Since you've obviously stuffed yourself full of thousands of delicious berries, you can't be hungry anymore. So I will just tell Frau Schmidt to skip your dinner.
It's all your fault. You should have told him the truth.
And made him boiling mad at us.
He's better starving to death.
We didn't do anything wrong. We just wanted to see her.
My stomach's making noises.
The least they could have done was to let us say hello.
I wonder what grass tastes like.
I feel awful.
When Fräulein Maria wanted to feel better, she used to sing that song. Remember?
Yes! Let's try it!
Have been delivered here lately?
Not many. I'll be glad when school reopens.
Oh, Liesl, you can't use school to escape your problems. You have to face them.
Oh, children, I've got so much to tell you all.
We have things to tell you too.
I'm sure you do.
The most important thing is, Father is going to be married.
Married?
Yes, to Barney's father.
Captain.
Good evening. All right, everyone, go inside and get your dinner.
Dinner!
Fräulein, you left without saying goodbye. Even to the children.
Well, it was wrong of me. Forgive me.
But why did you?
Please don't ask me. Anyway, the reason no longer exists. Aha, Fräulein Maria, you've returned. Isn't it wonderful, Georg? I wish you every happiness, Baroness. And you too, Captain. The children tell me that you are going to be married. Thank you, my dear.
Fräulein. You are back here to stay.
Only until arrangements are made for the new governess. Oh, Georg, you have no idea what kind of trouble I'm having trying to decide what to give you for a wedding present. How do you feel about yachts? And where do we go on our honeymoon? Now, that's a real problem.
Look, Elsa.
Yes, Georg?
It's no use, you and I.
You and I? What do you mean?
I mean, I am being utterly dishonest to you. And unfair to both of us. When two people talk of marriage...
No! Don't say another word, Georg. You're much too independent. And I need someone who needs me desperately. Now, if you do allow me, I'll get back to Vienna where I belong. And somewhere out there is a young lady who I think will never be a nun.
The captain is perplexed. Yet, relieved. He goes in search of Maria. Thank you.
Maria, I just thought I might find you here.
Was there anything you wanted?
Oh, no. Please sit down. You know, I was thinking and wondering about two things. Why did you run away to the Abbey? And what was it that made you come back?
Well, I had an obligation to fulfill, and I missed the children.
Only the children?
No. Yes.
Isn't it right? I should have missed them.
Oh, yes, of course. I was just hoping that perhaps you might just, perhaps.
Yes.
Well, nothing was the same when you were away. And everything will be wrong again after you leave.
I just hope the Baroness will be able to make things fine for you.
Maria, there isn't going to be any Baroness.
There isn't?
We have called off our engagement.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, you can't marry someone when you're in love with someone else, can you?
Captain and Maria get married at the Abbey, where they are blessed by the Reverend Mother and the other nuns. They then leave for their honeymoon. And leave the children under Max's care. Suddenly, they get an unpleasant visit from Herr Zeller and Corporal Rolf.
Hey, Detweiler.
Hi, Hitler.
Hey, good afternoon, Herr Zeller. Rolf.
Perhaps you haven't heard.
Hi, Hitler.
Oh, Heil Hitler.
Herr Zeller,
how can I help you?
We want to know when that captain will be returning.
Well, actually you see, he is on his honeymoon trip.
We are aware of that.
I hope you'll allow the festival to go on.
Why should it not go on? Nothing in Austria has changed. Singing and music will show this to the world.
Heil Hitler!
Rolf?
Liesel, you'll take this telegram from Berlin. Give it to the captain as soon as he comes. Heil Hitler!
But Rolf!
Heil Hitler!
Rolf!
Heil Hitler!
Things do change in Austria. A war breaks out between the Germans and the Austrians. The Fawn Trap family decides to escape and plan to use the Austrian folk festival as a ruse.
Regretfully they tell us, but firmly they compel us to say goodbye to you.
So long, farewell, all we just say goodnight. We hate to go and leave this pretty sight.
Helps the Fawn Trap family to give Zeller and his Nazi men the slip. The furious Zeller gives chase. Finally, the Fawn Traps escape the clutches of the Nazis. They travel over the Utersberg Mountains till they reach the land of freedom.
Gretel was by Schnevi. Dia Agarwal was Marta. Brigitta was portrayed by Tamanna Taneja. Nafisa played the role of Louise. Kurt was played by Harsh Sharma. Tarun Philip enacted Friedrich. Lisa was played by Ragini Singh. Shaurya Padhyay played the role of Rolf. Frau Schmidt was enacted by Jyoti Bhatia. Max was portrayed by Shushant Shanghari. Let's get acquainted with Captain Phone Trap's guests, Shushant George and Deepika Thapa. Kumar Abhishek and Nupur Bagri. Subir Sarkar and Jahan Gazdar. Baroness Elsa Schrader was enacted by Richa Shah. Captain Fontrap was portrayed by Abhishek Ghosh. Fraulein Maria was played by Debadrita Ghosh. Our narrator for the evening was Abhinav Nair. Presenting to you our youngest stars, the puppets, Vishnu, Darren, Aditya, Brian, Anisha, Cyrus, Taranveer, Kulveer, Edina, Yukta, Arshia, Irani, and Ritika. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for our backstage crew. Parnika Pralay, Naval Battiwala, Abhinav Kumar, Siddharth Shekhar, G. Pallavi, Swati Sharan, Sonu, Bobby, Suraj, and Godwin. The lights were done by Jayant Sinha, Shushant George, Bhavesh Sangani, Prashant Cha, Pratish Ray, Kumar Abhishek, Akash Agarwal, T. Abhijit, and Manish Kumar Singh. Sound management was done by Ramyajit Gupta. The interludes were played by Jitesh Irudairaj. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for the Sound of Music Choir, Shannon Daniel, Ayush Banerjee, Asad Ali, Aishwarya Paul, Nirvika Ahuja, Rahul Basu, Niharika Robbi, Akshay Kirti, Amal Prasad, Priya Tirki, Bliss, Mohammad Nafis, Shrijita Kar, Aditesh Mitra, Suroji Chakrabarti, Lavanya Chakrabarti, Rohan Bedi, Manav Banerjee, Shayantika Biswas, Smriti Narayan, Nilova Das, Mayuk Sen, Adhiraj Roy, Vernon Daniel, Riya Srivastav, Rishita Ganguly, Ira Smita Tirki, Chirag Mukherjee, Rishabh Kumar. And now to our lead singers, Smita Sarkar, Shruti Vijay Raghavan, Akshay Ranjan, Akshay Sharan, and Pratyush Panjwani. Ladies and gentlemen, take cover. The Nazi soldiers were Shashant George, Kumar Abhishek, Shaurya Upadhyay, Akash Aniketan, Akash Agarwal, led by Herr Zeller, Subir Sarkar. Subir also played the role of Franz, the butler.
Nothing is possible without divine grace. The divine grace for this play was ably provided by our nuns. Sister Margarita, played by Atrey Roy Chaudhary. Sister Bernice, played by Bini Saini. And Mother Abbess, played by Alisha Malik. Weren't they wonderful, audience? I want to hear a loud round of applause.
now like to introduce to you three special people without whose creative support the Sound of Music would not have been possible today. Meet our first guest, Mrs. Jenny Chatterjee, Mr. Derek Fernandez, who enhanced our musical skills. Can we have you two on stage, please?
I never ventured to do a musical. It was thanks to all the staff of Loyola School who gave me the courage to put up this play, and I do hope that all of you enjoyed it. Handsome is, they say, is what handsome does. Loyola is what Loyola does. And certainly this evening, Loyola has shown that they are miles ahead of any other school in Jamshedpur. I've always said that if I'm anything today, it's because of Loyola School.
So, first and foremost, I'd like to thank the today's chief guest, Mr. Muthuraman, who came over, although he had lots of engagements. He wanted to leave the place within 15 minutes, but he said, "Father, difficult to get up from the chair." Father, you mean to these are Loyola only school children, or did you hire people from somewhere else? You mean about actors and actresses? That shows how well you acted, my dear children. And basically, the credit goes to our director, Dr. Amit Chatterjee. So I thank you sincerely on behalf of the whole Loyola staff and students for the efforts that you put in. You know, all these wonderful shows cannot be performed or staged in this manner unless there are generous sponsors. A school cannot afford so easily. So here are a few sponsors who have been very, very generous towards Loyola. As usual, they have been in the past, this time all the more, and I'm sure they will be in future too. And they are Tata Steel, SSM Coal, Timken, Sri Leather, Sizer Enterprises, MN Dastur, Tramco, Goyal, relish, whose food packets all of you relished, then Zen, then Chappan Bhog, also food packets. I'm sure you're looking forward to this evening too, my dear boys and girls. Then my sincere thanks to the XLRI administration for the hall. So, my dear children, in the end, I know all of you have gone through a lots of hardships, isn't it? Along with your parents, but this evening you must have realized what joy, what satisfaction can give you out of these hardships. And you have realized it from the applause, the applause from the audience. So my sincere thanks to each of the actors and actresses, then the choir, and all the people on the performed at the backstage quietly but with great dedication. Thanks to all of you.
Thank you.
You know, many of you are trying to give the credit for this performance to man speaking here right now. In fact, 90% of the credit should go to Father Augustine Vattamattam. God bless you.
God bless you, Father, and thank you so much for all the cooperation that you extended. I'm extremely happy that victory always belongs to Father Victor. We have Father Augustine, who actually conceived the play right in the beginning. Thank you so much, Father Augustine, for coming here.
I can make it easier.
Yeah. children, do re mi fa so and so on, are only the tools you use to build a song. Once you have these notes in your heads, you can sing a million different tunes by mixing them up like this. So do la fa mi do re. Can you do that?
So do la fa mi do re.
So do la ti do re do.
So do la ti do re do.
Now put it all together.
So do.
So we put in words, one word for every note, like this.